Hi, I'm Liz Peek, and I'm a grad student in Arnold Chin's lab here at UCLA, and we're in the Department of Urology, so we focus mostly on prostate and bladder cancer. And my project specifically focuses on prostate cancer and the interaction of the immune system with the tumor, and why exactly our immune systems in some cases can't fight off the tumor. I have different tumor models that I can work with and different immune system components that I can work with that have specific genes knocked out so that we can really look at what type of immune system defects are allowing this cancer to continue to grow. So tumors a lot of times will hijack normal pathways, normal growth pathways, into facilitating the tumor growth instead of just normal cell pathways. Why exactly they can do that and why the immune system allows them to do that is what I'm working on in prostate cancer. I was working with the liquid nitrogen, which is basically the coldest thing that we have in lab. And we use it to keep cells frozen. So if we want to have cells usable at a later time, say we get a bunch of patient cells at one point and we want to save them for later, we can freeze them in a very specific way and then just keep them really, really cold in the liquid nitrogen. Then later we can thaw them out and they'll actually still be alive. I grew up in Virginia, specifically around Richmond, Virginia. I lived there my whole life, then went to the University of Virginia. I'm an only child and my mom stopped working when I was born and then went back to nursing school later. She and I used to just go do things and she would take me to the science museum and I would get to play with all the fun things there. And so I've always really thought that science was super cool. My parents are both scientists in some respect. My dad is a chemical engineer and actually my parents met at a chemical company. My mom is an oncology nurse actually, so she and I get to have fun conversations about what I do. Science is so broad to me. I grew up wanting to know everything. So I've always been interested in biology. I'm sure that some of my scientific bent is from my parents, but in general, I always loved biological systems and I always wanted to kind of do biological research on diseases. I focus a lot on cancer and personally I find that really, really interesting because in general, cancer is just a failure of normal cells to do normal cell things. Real interest in science as a career, I think, came in college. I did some work in a lab at UVA, and they worked on cancer therapies. And I found the work that we did really, really interesting and thought, this is what I wanna work on. The idea of being able to design therapeutics, I think, is fascinating. And as I've gotten more into the field, I've realized that cancer is a disease of aging, and so as we get older, it's only going to impact us more and more. And I would love to be able to contribute to some of the therapies that now are making cancer a chronic disease, so people no longer are dying from this and they can continue living on until old age, just like everyone else. I work with Hanwei, who's someone in the lab all the time, and Wang Song, who's also in the lab all the time. And then I also have two undergrads who I'm helping to train, Minji and Felicia. And with them, they come in when they don't have classes and they learn different techniques and I try and teach them about what we're doing. Our lab is very collaborative. Most everyone is working on at least partially on every project at any given time because there are so few of us. So it's really helpful to have that interaction. And our PI, Arnold, is in the lab some of the time, and then other times he's either in surgery or doing doctor-y sorts of things. The best thing is that he brings us a lot of tissue samples, which is awesome. My hopes and dreams for my research are really that we learn something very fundamental about how the immune system interacts with the tumor, and how the tumor affects the immune cells that are in the same environment, and that becomes a way that we can exploit for treatments. I would love to be able to develop a small molecule or some sort of therapy that gets rid of those cells or inhibits them or somehow prevents them from helping the tumor. And then that drug would be helpful to patients. Talking to young people, I would say that science is really interesting if you're creative, if you wonder about how the world works and how different things work and you like to take things apart and put them back together or make things better. I think science is a really interesting place to be. You never do the same thing all the time. You're always doing an experiment and then learning from that and then moving on to something else. And regardless of what field you find interesting, science in general is just testing hypotheses. And I think there's a quote I heard from Mythbusters that's the difference between science and screwing around is writing it down.